This doesn't look like the JSON we're used to. Well, the truth is, this data is JSON. It's just JSON in its raw byte form. That's what all these hex numbers are. In order to actually understand and use it, we'll need to convert it from raw JSON into an object we can use in Swift. And guess what? Swift has just the class for us. It's called NSJSON Serialization, and it allows us to convert JSON into objects like arrays or dictionaries, and vice versa. Since we want to go from JSON data to an object, we'll use a method called JSONObjectWithData. This takes in our raw JSON data and returns either an NSDictionary or an NSArray, which are both usable in Swift. Okay, let's go use it in our code. We can start back in this little spot, where we're printing the raw data. Now, instead of printing it, let's convert it. We should start by using optional binding to get our data out of optional form and make sure that it exists. Then, let's create an object that will eventually contain our parsed dictionary result. We can call it parsed result. And now, let's add in that method nsjsonserialization.jsonObjectWithData with data as our first parameter and allow fragments as the second parameter and save that result to our parsed result. What's this? Can call throw but is not marked with try and the error is not handled. It looks like this method can throw an error. Let's use Swift's do catch block and the try keyword to handle it. If you haven't seen this error handling syntax before or would like a refresher, feel free to check out the Swift syntax course. But overall, this will be pretty straightforward. Let's add the do catch block like so, and then put in the try keyword in front of the potentially problematic method call. And up, looks like that was it. Should we try and print? First, we should probably change this data to parsed result. Let's try and print it. Grab new image. Cool. This looks more like it. For the record, serialization means converting an object into a stream of bytes, and deserialization usually means the opposite, converting a stream of bytes into an object. But for simplicity, Apple groups these both under NSJSON serialization.